Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here to join me today. Thank you. Did you feel the magnitude 2.9 earthquake that happened along the Hayward Fault last night? 10:39 p.m. local time near the Koldakat tunnel. Yeah, look at that. And there's the interstate, smack dab on the interstate. The red lines are the Hayward Fault. Let's bring it out a little bit. I've been following the earthquakes that have been occurring over the last couple weeks coming from Southern California along the San Andreas Fault and up there by Calaveras Fault. Yep. Twitter blew up with all the reports of feeling the earthquake. 6.2 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. Over 4,466 people sent in reports to USGS. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4, which means it was felt indoors by many people, outdoors by a few. At night, if they were sleeping, they would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling. Automobiles rocked noticeably. Some of the reports that were sent in to EMSC, one here says they were leaning against a wall, felt like someone slammed a door on the same wall. It was evidently one quick, sharp jolt. Another person there in Piedmont said they heard the wave rolling in, then a big shake. One quick jolt. Everyone's reporting one quick jolt, and it was. One of us in the same room felt it and heard it, and the other didn't. Another person said it felt strong. There seemed to have been a loud boom. Not that much movement, very short duration. Rumble, then a shake, back and forth. Pretty good roaring, shaking getting stronger. Heard it more than felt it. Thought my dog was shaking the bed. Felt a brief rumbling followed by a loud noise. And a big jerk motion, maybe lasted 2 to 3 seconds. Another one says thought someone was running upstairs. Felt a little house shake. Here's that earthquake from a monitor there in Lucas Valley. And this other one is across over there by Marin County, Marshall, California. There was two smaller quakes since this one occurred. There's the one and the second one. Here is the signature from two different monitors and the spectrogram for MCCM. Yeah, that's bright, and you can see the gases that came up, water. That's from Marshall. And then the one on the left, that's a borehole, a very deep well dug into the ground from Lucas Valley. We'll make that one bigger. All right, there you go. They did not fudge about the size of the earthquake. Let me bring it down so you can see it. It was actually a magnitude 2.99. See that at the bottom? MD 2.99. All right, the other two earthquakes. Let's see, we'll bring this back up. The first one right there. There's a spectrogram for the first one of the two that came afterwards. If you're earthquake sensitive, you might have felt it. It came in as a magnitude 1.76 right there. And then the second one, which is marked in red right there, we'll go to its signature. Oh, that's probably quite a ways from where this occurred. It's got a long P wave. That one comes in as a magnitude 2.05. USGS is reporting that. It came in a few seconds later, or their time is off. Portola Valley came in as a magnitude 2.0. Yeah, 5.3 miles below sea level. Right down there. Then they got another one which doesn't show up. A smaller one, a 0.9. One person said they did feel that 2.0. That would have been at 5:52 a.m. local time. So I imagine many of you did feel this magnitude 2.9. What did it feel like? Did you have damage? Are you prepared for a large earthquake? Because this is the Hayward Fault. It is overdue for a major earthquake. Please put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.